head.
Your name is Bill Polk. You're an intelligence officer with the CIA. I need you to remember.
Remember what?
Jan Stroop, Dutch program.
He can fire missiles anytime, anywhere. Where did you put him?
That is all we need to know.
I don't remember nothing.
Who are you?
They stopped your husband in my head. Looking for details that he knew before he was killed.
Washington, Berlin, Beijing would be graveyards.
Can you feel what Billy felt?
He loves you so much.
There's too many lives at stake! They don't matter!
They do to me!
Criminal.
What goes around, goes around.
Hey guys, it's Nicholson 1968, and what you just saw was a trailer, part of a trailer to the new movie coming out, Criminal, April 15th, with Kevin Costner, Gary Oldman, Tommy Lee Jones, and more specifically, Ryan Reynolds. And for those who have followed me, you know that I did a breakdown of Selfless. It's a movie with Ben Kingsley and Ryan Reynolds. It is about an eccentric architect builder that is dying, that he wants to move his consciousness and body into a clone, his mind into another vessel, a younger looking vessel. And that person was played by Ryan Reynolds. And if you haven't seen that video breakdown, I'll share the links to that. But notice here in this movie, Kevin Costner has been uploaded hit memories from a guy in the movie called Bill Pope, which is played by, guess what? Ryan Reynolds again. The moving of consciousness, folks. Transhumanism, knocking at the door, things I was talking about years ago. But the reason for this movie is pre-programming. It'll be one of many coming out. Notice that to save humanity from nuclear war, destruction, we must upload memories into this technology. So for the normal viewer, going to watch the movie, it'll probably be a good movie. You know, just a normal movie, but I'm telling you, when you watch it, the savior is technology uploaded the information into a new vessel, to a new human being. It's going to be, I'm glad we could do this so we can save humanity. See, it's all symbolism pushing technology. I want to point out some things very interesting in this community of Hollywood, the illusions and how they do the things. Notice that Ryan Reynolds was married to none other than Scarlett Johansson, and she always plays pretty much the same kind of parts too. She played in The Island. She was cloned. She is the computer behind the movie Her, where she is an automated, intelligent OS computer program that a real human falls in love with her. She obviously is the star of Lucy, and that whole breakdown of technology and where humanity is going. Notice she plays the same kind of parts. She is also going to be playing the star role in upcoming movie in 2017, Ghost in the Shell. And it is going to be put out by none other than Disney. Yep, Disney. Walt Disney, Freemason himself, studios, will be putting all this propaganda out for the young minds to see. A note about this film is it's 113 minutes long, 33. or one time 13. 13. You can get 13 out of it, and you can get 33. And you can say, well, Nicholson, you're stretching. Well, I'm just telling you how the elites communicate within the structure. That this is their staple. Also want to share this. It is produced, one of the production companies is Millennium Films. Millennium Films. Their logo is none other than a cube. Now notice in the Christian prophecy, Christ returns and he reigns for 1,000 years, a millennium. Again, copying the creator with actually the name Millennium Films. But here's something interesting. Guess what? Millennium Films has changed their name to Alchemy. Millennium Entertainment changed their name to Alchemy. For you guys who are following me, you know quite well about Alchemy. For those who have never seen any of my videos at all, you can watch a lot of my videos. It tells you what the elites are trying to do through Alchemy. Of course, we are told that all Alchemy was about was trying to get base metals to transfigure into gold, or the transmutation of base lead into gold. But the Egyptians and some of history in the past, King Solomon, there was a deeper meaning behind it, of the magic behind alchemy. So it's funny that, it's not funny, but it's very curious that they changed their name to Alchemy. And it's more of a staple of what I've been saying for a long time, of what they are trying to accomplish. And I'm here to tell you is, I told people, I'm going to say this again, I'm going to keep saying it, I told people since 1998 about transhumanism. Look around the websites, look around the channels now. It's here, folks. People who thought it was crazy, it's here, folks. In many shapes, forms, fashions, the attack on the temple of God, humanity, through, I mean, you name it. What's going on? You've got a couple of things going on. You've got transhumanism, where people are actually in the future wanting to upgrade themselves. That is an agenda going on. But then you also have another kind of secret behind the scenes agenda, trying to adapt humanity to iron and metal and technology with chemtrails, nanoparticles, nanobots, black programmable matter, things that they are trying to do behind the scenes that you're not privy to, that people are seeing, experiencing through Morgellons disease, which is a real disease that the doctors are trying to dismiss as their delusional. There's a reason why holistic doctors are being killed and showing up mysteriously deaths all the time. Just watch the news. Search. These doctors that are getting away from, you know, traditional medicine methods, away from big pharma, are dying. Just mysteriously dying. I mean, it's not one here and every 6 months one here. No, no. I mean, it's happening, folks. Right in front of us. And so here's an example of this guy on the screen. Why should you come to my channel? You got this guy on the screen. Mark Dice has over 439 subs. Good for him, okay? He's exposing darkness, right? Let me tell you something. Keisha admits she's a Satanist. Is that exposing anything? Ask yourself, is he exposing anything? If he comes on and tells you Marilyn Manson worships the devil, has he told you anything new? No, he is not. And that's what he does. He comes on Beyonce, he just goes down the row, and he's all about subs, views, whatever. I don't know the man's heart, but I'm just telling you, this is a perfect example. My dog can expose Keisha. My dog can expose Madonna, okay? And my dog can spot this all-seeing eye too, okay? But let's take it to the next level, okay? How about a musical group called They Might Be Giants? Nanobots, the name of the album. See, do you see anybody exposing them? No, because it's not obvious to the physical eye, and what people are looking at, some of these YouTube channels out here, looking at physical stuff, follow the leader with no discernment. That's right, I'm saying it. Is, look, I had to step up in 1998 and be a leader and tell people about downloading your consciousness is coming, telling you about stuff that didn't even have a name at that point, to a certain degree, transhumanism and the transhumanist movement. I had to step out there and look like an idiot for a couple of years, and guess where we're at? People are finding my website, finding my channel, and thank you for coming back and apologizing, thinking I was crazy or whatever. Again, I don't know everything. And when I come across something that I don't know or I'm not sure of, I'm not going to do a video on it. Everybody's asked me, Nicholson, when are you going to do a flat earth video? I may do one, I may not. But I have to do my research before I put something out. And that's something that has not... I just haven't been led to investigate it right now. I have other things. I don't do requests. I don't go every day and look at the topics like these guys do. Let's do one on Caitlyn Jenner and Bruce Jenner and that whole thing. If that's what you want to do and you put it out, of course it's going to get views. But I'm not doing one. I'm not led to do that. I don't put a video out every 5 minutes to just do whatever's hot, you know, at the moment. See, here's the difference is I'm led by what's important to the creator and what he wants me to show. And I'm trying to do that versus what others are doing is trying to show what's important to man and distraction and look over here, whatever. Notice what I'm showing, and that's why I call it the one game, and everything else is smoke and mirrors. Now, don't get me wrong, there's other things that are important, but and other people, that may be their expertise to investigate hoaxes and other things like that, but I am being shown to show you things that are right here now happening that you need to know about. Whether Caitlyn Jenner wants to be a man or a woman, I don't really care. It doesn't affect me. Don't, unless you come to my door and try to force me to be a woman and do a sex change, then I have an issue there. But until that, it's nothing to me. It's a waste of time. So
here's an example of what I'm talking about. I just did a Super Bowl video right after the video last month, and I told you, and I'm going to show you a little clip from the video. I told you that tech would be the trigger. And in that video, it uses telephones. Anything is going to be a trigger. And I took directly from Rihanna's anti-diary video and some other things from movies, showing you what the enemy is after using technology, programmable matter, sound, frequencies, it's all there. Nanotechnology in the chemtrails, things that are coming that is moving forward with the next agenda. I'm going to play a section of this video that most of you've seen, but after that I'm going to follow it up with a real news event that just happened. And it's going to happen more and more. Watch and see. Just like I told you about transhumanism back in the day, you thought I was crazy. I'm telling you now, you're going to watch it and you go, oh, this is crazy. And then guess what? 5-10 years from now, they're going to go, oh, wait a minute. Nicholson called it. I'm just telling you, it's not me. It's something greater than me that is sharing with me, that I'm sharing with you, that I'm telling you as sure as I'm sitting here. And here's the proof. I just told you. Here it is. It's right in front of you. I can't make this stuff up, guys. So, and I'm going to show that, and then I'm going to move on with some other little bit deeper stuff to show you what is in the music that's deeper, not just on the surface, that is out there, that these, whatever you want to call them, shields, sub hogs, whatever you want to call them, that are trying to tell people this and that that don't have any discernment. That's just a distraction from getting down to the nitty gritty and the deeper things of the one game that's going on. So here you go.
My voice is my power. My mark will be permanent. The transformation is coming, and there is strength in numbers.
Coverage continues tonight with Ken Kolker, who has uncovered some new disturbing information about Dalton from those police interviews. Ken?
Yeah, this report here was released by the Kalamazoo City Attorney's Office this afternoon, and it reveals some of the disturbing things that were said during the interviews in the hours after the mass killings.
Dalton told police little at first, pleading the Fifth Amendment. But police kept pushing, saying the families of his victims and his family deserved answers. He softened a bit, saying he did not know a child had been shot and that he was sorry for that. But then it quickly turned bizarre. Dalton told police that the Uber app on his phone had taken over. He had only recently started driving for Uber and spent that night picking up and dropping off fares, all during that shooting spree. He said he saw the Eastern Star symbol, then the devil pop up on his phone through the Uber app. He described the devil as a quote-unquote horned cowhead that would give him assignments. He said he picked his targets randomly, but that he did not recall the killings at Seelekia. But he told police he remembered the shootings at the Cracker Barrel, says he never aimed and didn't remember the feeling of the gun in his hand, only the sound of pop, pop, pop. Dalton was wearing a bulletproof vest at the time of his arrest and was carrying a loaded 9mm handgun. He told police he did not get into a shootout with them because the color of the Uber app went from black to red.
Now, Dalton had no known mental health issues before this, which is why he could legally own a gun. But a judge has ordered a psych exam to see if he is competent to stand trial. As for police, we spoke with Chief Hadley, who says he doesn't believe he was motivated by that Uber app. Live in Kalamazoo, Ken Kolker, 24-Hour News 8.
All right, Ken, yeah. Now, more questions rather than answers in a very complex case. Ken Kolker reporting live. Thank you for that.
Well, there you go, guys. Right there. The beginning. I'm going to mention, before I go down the road of breaking down some things of the group, musical group, They Might Be Giants, and getting more in depth than that, but I do want to touch on right here before I play another clip for you about nanobots. They Might Be Giants released an album March 8th, 2016, after the Super Bowl. I did a video of the Super Bowl. Part of that clip is I just showed you. But the other part that you haven't seen, unless you've gone to my website, mentions the Black Awakening, Black Ops, the Rise of the Satanic Soldier, which involves MK Ultra, technology, things of this nature. So, things that, if you've not been in the conspiratorial community, you would think we're just nuts. But I'm telling you, and that's why I'm showing you this video, things that people thought we were nuts about, you better wake up. you better wake up very quickly. I'm going to tell you, let's just take this album for instance. Phone Power. That's the name of the new album, guys. Phone Power. They Might Be Giants, just released right after what I told you in this clip, in this video. Now let's look at the titles, okay? Let's look at the titles. Track 17, Black Ops. Track 15, Shapeshifter. Remember I did Can You Hear Me? Now with Haunted by Beyonce. Guess what track number 12 is? I'll Be Haunting You. You've not seen that video, guys. Can you? It's a two-part series. Lucifer's Vessel, Artificial Intelligence. Better go watch it. You got track number 9, Sold My Mind to the Kremlin. Kremlin is Russia. It is speaking of the 2045 project, which is sponsored by Russia, the Avatar Project. Telling you. Track 16, Bills, Bills, Bills. Here you go, you want to get some deep stuff? Bills, Bills, Bills. What's it talking about? Ah, Bills, Bills, Bills. Sung by Destiny's Child. Guess what? The name of the album is The Writing is on the Wall. Okay, Bills, Bills, Bills. Writing's on the Wall. What did Jonathan Cleck tell you? And what did he discover on the back of your dollar? Bills, 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 Bills. Almost every single false flag event is on the Bills, Bills, Bills. The Writing is on the Walls. Destiny's Child, Beyonce, Illuminati, all connections here. This is what I do is I've told you before, guys, if you just look at 9/11, you'll never see it coming. Just like these titles, just like this music. If you just look at one thing or just one title, you'll never see it. Put them all together. They're telling you a story within a story. This is how they do this. So let's look at some other tracks. Track 6, pretty telling here. Trouble, Awful, Devil, Evil. Track 7, here's a tricky one for you. Eklanablumba, or Eknalumba. It's not even a word, but it is to the elite because if you unscramble it, it's ambulance. And what's the logo on every ambulance? It is a serpent twined on a medical staff. And that logo, anybody that's followed me for a while knows what that means. You have track 2 now, I Love You for Psychological Reasons. What's that mean? Exactly what we've been talking about, MKUltra. Your love you for psychological reasons. Your mind, messing with your mind. The enemy, Satan. So I'm not going to dwell too much on this album. I'm going to move forward with more of medical for you guys out there. If you don't want to believe in the manipulation in movies and music, I'm going to enlighten you with some scientific technology out there that we already have. This is coming from TED Medical. And as always, it's going to be presented as a good thing. And to address this, I agree, it could be a good thing, just like replacing limbs, anything with technology, you may have replacing limbs, replacing certain parts of your body. Where we're going, though, is when evil men take this technology too far and do something with it that they're not supposed to. So I will share this video with you right now, and I'll be back with some more breakdowns on They Might Be Giants.
So one word of notice before we begin, all the technologies you're going to see here now are real. Now let's imagine a few years into the future, into the near future hopefully, Donna will arrive to the hospital for her due surgery, and instead of being prepped for anesthesia for the OR, the surgeon will just take a syringe. Inside the syringe, there are millions of tiny robots, of tiny machines that will be injected into Donna's bloodstream. They will autonomously locate the place they need to be in. They will excise out the injured tissue. They will remove dead cells. Then they will stimulate and guide the regrowth of healthy cells across those tissue gaps. They will release drugs that relieve pain and reduce inflammation. And all the while, Donna will be sitting on a chair, eating a sandwich. So these nanobots have been envisioned in the past 30 years by people like Eric Drexler and Robert Freitas and Ray Kurzweil. Today I'm going to show you that these robots exist here in Israel. And I'll show you this syringe, which I brought from my lab. So this syringe has inside it 1,000 billion robots. So these robots are each 50 nanometers long, which you can, as you can see in this slide under the microscope. So to carry out medical and therapeutic procedures in our body with the utmost precision, we need to be able to control molecules. Controlling molecules is a very simple challenge in modern science and technology. For example, we can put the drugs in particles from which they diffuse slowly. We can attach the drug to a carrier, which takes some place. But this is not real control. When we're thinking about control, we're thinking about processes in real world around us, and what happens when we want to control a process that's beyond our capabilities as humans. We just connect this process to a computer and let the computer control this process for us. We just connect this process to a computer and let the computer control this process for us. Okay? So that's what we do. But obviously, this cannot be done with drugs because the drugs are so much smaller than computers as we know them. The computer is, in fact, so much bigger. It's about 100 million times bigger than any drug molecule. Our nanobots, which were in this syringe, solve this problem because they are, in fact, computers the size of molecules. And they can interact with molecules, and they can control molecules directly. So there's an interesting question. How do we build a robot or a machine the size of a molecule? So the simple answer would be, we can use molecules to build this machine. So we're using molecules, but we're not using just any molecule. We're using the perfect, most beautiful molecule on Earth, at least in my opinion, which is DNA. And in fact, every part of the robot, every part of our nanorobots, moving parts, axes, locks, chassis, software, everything is made from DNA molecules. And these researchers also gave us computer-aided design tools that enable everyone, very, very simply, to design objects from DNA. So these CAD tools, amazingly, enable us to focus on the shape we want, forgetting the fact that these structures are, in fact, assemblies of molecules. So this is, for example, a shape. The computer can actually turn it into DNA molecules. And the output of this CAD software, as you can see, is a spreadsheet with fragments of DNA, which you can attach to a message and send to a company, one of 2 dozen companies that make DNA by order, and you'll get those DNAs several days later to your doorstep. So let's have a look at our nanorobots. So this is how the nanorobot looks like. It's built from DNA, as you can see. And it resembles a clamshell in which you can put cargo. You can load anything you want, starting from small molecules, drugs, proteins, enzymes, even nanoparticles. Virtually any function that molecules can carry out can be loaded into the nanobot, and the nanobot can be programmed to turn on and off these functions at certain places and at certain times. This is how it controls molecules. And so this particular nanorobot is in an off state. It's closed. It securely sequesters anything you put, any payload you put inside, so it's not accessible to the outside of the robot. For example, it cannot engage target cells or target tissues. But we can program the nanobot to switch to an on state based on molecular cues it finds from the environment. So programming the robot is virtually like assembling a combination lock using disks that recognize digits. But of course, instead of digits, we're assembling disks that recognize molecules. So these robots can turn from off to on, and when they do, any cargo inside is now accessible. It can attack target cells or target tissues or other robots, which you'll see later on. And we already have, as you can see, architectures of interacting nanorobots that can emulate logical operators. And you can use this as modular parts to build any type of universal computer you want that can control. We already have systems that can control multiple drugs simultaneously as a result of biocomputers. This is real universal computing in a living animal. Now, we already have systems that have computing capacity of an 8-bit computer like Commodore 64.
So there you go. Nanobots sold to you as the wave of the future to save and genetically upgrade humanity. And like I said, behind the scenes, what the evil men are doing with this technology, God only knows. And he shares with me what is being done behind the scenes. But I'm going to get right into a group called They Might Be Giants. And if you don't understand now what that means, they might be giants, what is being told to you goes back to Genesis 6:4. So we're going to go to, and I'll get into that later, we're going to go into this album that was released 2013, Nanobots, track number 2 on the album. Track number 3, Black Ops again. Okay, Secret Missions, Black Ops, mysterious stuff going on. Let's jump to track 13, Hive Mind. Hive Mind. That sound familiar to anybody out there? Hive Mind. Connecting you. All Hive Mind. 14, Decision Makers. These are the decision makers, people. Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton, and Donald Trump are not your decision makers. If you're still in that world, then sorry, I'm just telling you that they are not the decision makers. Those are the puppets. We're going to jump to track 19, Replicant. Let me tell you what a replicant is. It's a fictional bioengineered android in the film Blade Runner. Virtual identical to an adult human, but has superior strength, agility, and variable intelligence depending on the model. So let's continue. Track number 1, You're on Fire. I don't have to say too much for that, do it guys, on that one. You're on Fire. Track number 4, Lost My Mind. Things what I've been shown and what's going on is when you take the mark of the beast, you will not have the mind of Christ. You will have something else. And they're telling you, you lost your mind. You're controlled some other way. You don't have free will anymore. Track number 9, Stone Cold Cool, the title. A coup? What's a coup? A coup is to overthrow whatever is in place now. Overthrow government. This is what's being told to us through this album, through titles. Track 7, Tesla and his discoveries. If you don't know about Nikola Tesla, some of his discoveries with electricity and things, you can look into some of the stuff. I guarantee you this is what I'm talking about. This technology that was destroyed eons ago, and it keeps getting destroyed for good reason, because they're using this technology for bad. Tesla wanted to use it for good. They took him out. They took him down. But anyway, this energy, this technology that he had discovered is also on here. Also, track number 11, Destroy the Past. There we go. That's part of it. Also, they want to destroy the past. That's why they do not want you understanding Genesis 6:4 and the Nephilim. They want you to continue to believe it's the sons of Seth, and the sons of God were another, has to do with Seth and that lineage. And that's what it's taught in seminars and churches all over the world, and for this reason. They do not want you understanding Nephilim, the Watchers, and the sharing of information with mankind that we were not supposed to partake of, and this leading us down this path. So let's look at the actual CD cover of Nanobots. That is a collage, you can't really make it out, but I will tell you, the original painting is done by, and excuse my pronunciations of this, Jean-Auguste Dominique Ingres. He is a French painter back in the 1800s, and the name of the painting that is on the CD cover is the Blue Lady, or the Lady in Blue. As you can see, it's actually the Princess Albert de Brigalo, which is from 1853, which it was painted. This artist also, interestingly, here we go, painted also the Baroni de Rothschild. He has a collection that he painted for the Rothschild collection. Strange, huh? Some connections. Now, what's more interesting about this is you can't tell from the CD cover, but if you go to the original painting and look in the background of exactly what is on the wall in the background of this picture, let's go look and see. And see what we have. None other than the double eagle of Freemason. New World Order. All the way back in the 1800s, the double eagle, double phoenix, whatever you want to say, the 33 Masonic, all the way back. So here you have this group that they may be giants, gives you a cover. They've got it somewhat collage confusion, but when you really research what the painting is, get down to it, of the painter that painted it actually did work for the Rothschilds. Back on the wall is telling you Freemasonic, secret society stuff on this cover. You think that's by accident? No, it is not. It is pretty much the elites know things. This is their language that is right in front of us, if anybody would take the time to look into some of these things. And, you know, that's the key. And that's why I keep referring back to people that think they have discernment, they think they have information that multiple subs are sub to, and they're telling you surface stuff. They're telling you shield stuff that has nothing to do with anything. And, you know, they'll go there and watch Beyonce, Lady Gaga stuff or whatever. And I have some of that too, but I go deeper into it. But this is what I'm trying to show you, is they might be giants. You're not going to find a video that says Illuminati exposed, they might be giants. If you do, please share the link with me, because I can't find one. So, but I look a little deeper. It's not me alone. I pray about things. I ask for guidance, what I'm supposed to show when I put out a video. I take my time. I try to. I know I'm not the best speller. I'm not the best speaker. Shoot me. You know, sorry. I'm just a normal man in between my job and my family to put these out and show you the deeper things. And there's so much with this group. I mean, they have songs out there from the album Why, Thinking Machine. Also, Then the Kids Took Over. Then the Kids Took Over. Who are you talking about? It's talking about the Nephilim, the Watchers, that came in to the Daughters of Men. That whole thing, the children, the offspring take over. I mean, it's all there. They're telling you this story. Many things into it. That's on the, not just on the surface level. They also have the album, The Flood. What do you think they're talking about? That again, going back to the days of Noah. They were on the earth in those days and afterwards, the flood. The track 7 on that one is called Particle Man. Things that we're talking about, molecules, DNA, Particle Man. I mean, you just have to pay attention to what they're trying to tell you here. You know, so, I mean, there's another album called Glean. And this is a very interesting. One of the songs on there is Hate the Villanelle. V-I-L-L-A-N-E-L-L-E. Let me tell you where the word comes from. It derived from Latin, then Italian, and is related to the initial subject of the form being the pastoral. So, what are they saying here? Hate the Villanelle. So, the word is pastoral, a sheep and its shepherd. The sheep and its shepherd. So, I mean, it's pretty obvious, folks, is what hate the pastoral, that word, what that meant is hate the sheep and the shepherd. And they're talking about Jesus Christ. That's the deeper meaning behind that title. We have another album by them called Indestructible Object. Came out in 2004. On the cover, the artwork is based on a famous work by an artist called Man Ray. So you've got the cover there, but based on this guy's artwork, you dig deeper, and here's what it's based on. Here's the picture of what it's based on, the indestructible object. Do you see anything there, guys? pyramid with an eye based on that. So this is what I'm talking about, is they're showing you stuff that's deeper behind it. And they're so far, the people that are doing this, is just, it's unbelievable, of just the symbolism and the things behind it. They also have another album called The Spine, and I've shown things in my video of The Spine. That's 33 vertebrae of the Illuminati and what they're trying to control up and down your spine. That's the pathway, all of the receptors of a normal human being has to do with the spine. And so, you know, they're telling you things on these albums again. You just got to put them together. Real quickly, I want to touch on a movie that was just released March 18th of this year, 2016. It is the third part in the Divergent series, the movie Divergent series, Allegiant. And I think this is where it's going in the future with the transhumanism versus the things they are attempting to do to, how do I say this? Throughout history, the elites have the problem reaction solution. They're causing the problem, you react to it, whatever that is, you want whatever it is, they swoop in with the solution. So this is how they're going to combat in the future those that are already going to want transhumanism. They have no problem with, but what are they going to do with those who don't want transhumanism and upgrade themselves? These things, genetically modified food, chemtrails, Morgellons, things that are happening to us, they want to control reproduction. They're going to spin it as the old way of creating life, the creator's way, man and a woman, is, it's just ancient. We can't be doing that anymore. We have to sanitize it, whatever it is, where you're pure and impure. This is where the movies are, and the propaganda, Watch What Happens, is pushing genetically changing DNA and upgrading all of this stuff. So I'm going to play a few clips of this movie that you'll see the propaganda spun here. The actual movie poster is telling. You've got as above, so below. Look at the top. You've got the white and the black. As above is spawning what's below. The mixing of the dark and the light, the checkerboard floor per se, the knowledge of good and evil that produces below a inferior race or inferior line. That's what they're telling you right here, is as above, so below, the black and the white. So they're going to spin it in the future is we can... You can choose your own male or female baby. You can choose blue eyes, green eyes. They're going to pit one against the other, pure against impure. All the while, if you know the truth of Jesus Christ and why he came, and you must, man is appointed, Hebrews 9:27, man is appointed to die once. See, that has to become a fairy tale in the future. And what I'm showing is probably not for this generation. It is for maybe your kids and kids' generation. I know we're close in the timeline, but there's still a ways to go. Still a couple of events have to come to pass. That's where this is going to come in, is those who are going to fight against transhumanism. They've got to spin it some other way. So I'll leave you a few clips here. Then after that, I'm going to just run off music titles from They Might Be Giants. I'm just going to play a little nice music, and I'm just going to put some titles on the screen, and you decide for yourself of what they're telling you behind the scenes. So I'll leave that with you for some little bonus material. Appreciate it, you guys, and all that you do and sharing, and love you. Till next time, this is Nicholson 1968.
We designed your city as an experiment. We believe it is the only way to recover the humanity we have lost. A And we created factions to ensure peace. But we believe there will be those among you who will transcend these factions. These will be the Divergent. They are the true purpose of this experiment. They are vital to humanity's survival.
Hello, and welcome to the Bureau of Genetic Welfare. In the early part of the 21st century, scientists first discovered a way to map, then edit, the human genome.
Or you can choose health. You can choose to settle for merely adequate, or you can choose excellent. A genetic solution puts you in control of your life. So why just hope for a better future when you can choose perfection? Choose Perfexia.
But what started as an attempt to erase humanity's faults almost erased humanity itself. Genetic modification deepened the rifts between people, and as they got more entrenched, the world began to tear apart until humanity crossed a line from which it could never return. In the ashes of civilization, a small group of genetically unmodified individuals established the Bureau of Genetic Welfare here at Chicago's O'Hare Airport. Our mission is to oversee a grand experiment to purify the human genome. That experiment is the city of Chicago. Your participation in the Bureau's work means you are now the guardians of the future. Your destiny begins today.
So I also want to address something here for the traditional Christian out there that has went to seminary and has all this indoctrination of that the sons of Seth, and not the Nephilim, that whole thing. People email me all the time and say, you know, Jesus Christ said that angels don't marry in heaven and they can't have sex, and this is just, it's heretic. You're a heretic, Nicholson, teaching the Nephilim thing. That's just, and I'm going to address this, okay? And you can't have it both ways, folks, okay? And I'm going to share scripture in up at the top with this. Jesus Christ's words were true. Yeshua, whatever you want to call him, Yeshua in Hebrew, which was translated to Jesus. Let me just tell you, they don't marry in heaven. They don't marry because they're spirit. They're angels. They don't have physical form. But that changes if they take physical form. And that's what is spoken of in Jude 1:6. They took physical form. They weren't supposed to, but that's what they did. Now, here's the thing. The story of Lot and the two angels that he took into Sodom with him. And he had to hide them in his home because they were so beautiful that the people of Sodom and Gomorrah, or Sodom, surrounded the house and wanted to have sex with them, bring them out right now. He had to actually offer up his daughters to them instead, instead of these two angels, even. And so you can't have it both ways, guys. You know, good angels can take physical form and they're so beautiful that the neighbors come around and want to have sex with them. But the bad angels can't take on physical form. So I wanted to address that of how much is not taught correctly in that. So anyway, so I'll leave you with some more bonus material, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Please share it. I understand if you don't, because it's pretty deep and people think you wacko, but I hope I have put enough in there for people that have no clue and think you're crazy for showing it. I understand people out there trying to show your family and friends or whatever. This is not for everybody. I know that. That's why I don't have, but you know, so many subs and followers, because it's not for the masses, because that unfortunately is part of the prophecy. The masses are asleep and only a few remnant are going to be awake toward the end. Thank you.